so this video is the filming locations for the movie Cedar Rapids. Now, while some of the locations used in this movie did take place in the state of Iowa, most of the locations used in this movie actually took place in Michigan, primarily in Ann Arbor, Michigan. So I was passing through the area and had a limited amount of time to spend tracking these locations down. So what I did is I spent more time on the main locations and less time on some of the smaller ones to compile this video, mainly because of the time I had to work with, but also with all the restrictions right now with COVID-19, it's made finding and seeing some of these locations a little more challenging. So I went ahead and put more emphasis on the main locations for this movie than I did everything that was used. So let's go ahead and get started, and I hope you enjoy it. Okay, so right off the bat, you start seeing a few of those real short clips of some locations in the movie, including this one. This would have been Tim's hometown. They kind of show him driving through, and you see these buildings here, the River Grill on the side of the brick building, kind of in the center of the screen, and the Dairy Queen here right next to it. Here's a shot of where that was taken. This is on East Main Street in Manchester, Michigan, which is just outside of Ann Arbor. And here you have the Westside United Methodist Church in Ann Arbor, Michigan. And it had a very brief appearance in the movie. This is where the service for Roger Lemke would have been held inside. And this is the exterior of that building. So you can see on off to the left where the main portion of the chapel has the kind of the peak ceiling, kind of like an A-frame. They filmed that scene right inside that. Okay, and this is the Ann Arbor Municipal Airport in Ann Arbor, Michigan. So you can see the building here off to the left, as well as the air traffic control tower on the right when Macy takes Tim to the airport when he's on his way. He's supposed to be leaving Wisconsin to head to Cedar Rapids for the convention. This is what the building looks like. It looks like it must be like a rental car center, just a little small little rental car center in Ann Arbor. And here off to the right is that air traffic control tower. Here look at Macy fixing Tim's hair. Look to the left. It says that you can kind of see it says Rhinelander Regional Airport on the sign, which would be in Wisconsin. But the reality of the matter is, look at the sign here, right at the kind of like the bottom here, clearly says Ann Arbor. So they put like a facade over top of this to make it look like he was leaving Wisconsin and not Michigan like it was in reality.
Okay, so I'm here in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and this hotel directly in front of me is the hotel that was used in the movie Cedar Rapids. This would have been called the Royal Cedar Suites in the movie. The sign would have been right up here. So there's some things that look similar as it did when it was when filming took place here. There's some things that don't. These columns here that support the carport, they would have all been brick, but you can see the outer post here, and then there's 1, 2, and 3 that run down along the entrances right there. So those three columns, they all would have had like a brick facade that was around them. You could also see what was like another level that would have been above this that was visible from that scene. I don't know if that was imposed, like superimposed into the shot, or if it was here and has since been taken down. But this is definitely where they filmed. You're going to see when I go inside how much it looks alike. But the funny thing is, the majority of this movie took place right here in this hotel. So they do show when Tim, you know, arrives at the hotel, he's all excited to be going to this conference. And you see him walking up this walkway right here, as I am. And he gets right about here, and standing right over here was Bree, and she asked him if he had a cigarette. And he strikes up a little conversation with her. But this, when he's talking with her, this pole right here, is, again, as I said, it was brick. He was standing right here in front of it. And then he eventually goes inside, and I'll show you around in there.
So this is from inside, and you would have seen this angle of Tim walking in with his luggage to the front desk through the front doors. And right here is the front desk where Tim was checking in, right about from the same angle. The countertop on the front desk has changed since filming, but this is where that shot would have been filmed.
Okay, so when Tim comes into the hotel to check in to his room, he would have come from this direction, made this turn, and they show him walking down this hallway in the direction that I'm walking. And he was on the phone with Macy, and he comes down here, and I'll show you where the room was used for the room that Tim, Ronald, and Dean Ziel stayed in this room. So some of the signs and things on the hotel have changed from the movie. But this is their room right here. It was the California suite is what you're seeing now, but I think it was called the Junior Suite, and it was room 112. So this is the hallway again. So this is where Tim comes walking down, and he's using his card. He's on the phone, and he's trying to get into the door. And that's when Ronald opens the door, kind of throws him for a loop because he's not sure who he is. So Ronald would have been standing obviously right here. And you can tell that this is the room that they use because the door swings in this direction, unlike the door over here that swings that way. And also, if you count there's a couple different little I don't know what you call them, like nooks. So if I don't know if you can see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see 5 of those little beams, nooks, whatever you want to call them, in the background on the hallway to where he was keying into the room. Another point, another way that you can tell that this is where they use is when he opens the door, when Ronald opens the door and Tim's standing here, this pole is visible. So he's sort of standing kind of in front of it, and you can see the framing of this window in the background. There's like a brown framing kind of through that plant there. It's a little harder to see, but you can see those in the background when Tim is standing there at the door when Ron greets him. Of course, Deansy later shows up, but this is the room that they used. Unfortunately, with COVID and everything going on, I'm not going to be able to go in.
Okay, so here's a image of the room. You can see Ronald standing there with Tim coming in. So this is what the suite looked like that they filmed in. And then I'm going to go ahead and show a image of what these suites look like here in the hotel currently. And you can see how it's the same sort of room. There's a few suites that look very much alike. I don't know if this is exactly the one, but you can see how it very much matches up with what they shot in the movie. Okay, so these are the same set of front doors that they show Deansy walking through. Deansy's definitely my favorite character in the movie. I think he's hilarious.
Deansy comes walking in there talking about stock my mini bar, something like that. But when Deansy's walking, he passes a guy he knows talking to a woman right here, and he makes like a lewd comment and goes in this direction. But this is where they would go to find their room. It would be in this direction, down this hall, and to the right.
Okay, here you get the first glimpse of the conference center that was used for the conference in Cedar Rapids. You can see Oren speaking at the podium here, and take a look to the left of him. You see the doorway that's there. Look above the doorway. It's like a half circle, almost looks like half of an orange, like orange segments, almost like slices of a cake. And then look at the doorways that are here. You can see how that perfectly matches up with the design. Unfortunately, this room in the conference center was closed because of COVID, so I wasn't able to go in, but this is an image of what it looks like inside, just to give you an idea of how some of those doorways look and match up for what was used for filming.
Okay, so this is the gym that they used in the movie where Tim and Joan are here working out. It's a small little gym here in the hotel. You can see it looks a little bigger because it has, this is a mirror. So this is kind of showing back towards where I'm standing, and then there's the windows where the pool is. But this is it. I mean, it's a small little room. But Tim would have been over kind of like over here in the direction I'm standing, and then Joan would have been running on a treadmill like over here. If I remember correctly, you could see that mirror in the background, or like literally like right beside her. And that's when she starts kind of messing with Tim's asking him if like he was checking her out. But this was it. This is a very small little gym, but they filmed that scene when they were here. Okay, so right here's a spot that they used where Tim would have been walking down this hallway kind of towards his room. The door over here would have said 107. It doesn't say that now, but that's what it said in the movie. It was depicted as that. But this is where Bree and her date were coming out. I believe it was this room right here. But they come out and she's kind of, she just walked past the 107 on there where Tim stops and greets her. But you can tell this is where they shot that that scene. This railing, how it comes down here to a point, you can see it was right here at this corner. I believe that pole is also visible, but it would have been like right about here if I want to match it up. Is where Bree and her date were kind of standing here, and Tim would have been talking to him right here, and that would have been room 107 in the movie.
Okay, and here's another shot of a scene filmed in the conference room for the hotel. The guys are having breakfast here in the morning, and again, this was closed up. But here's a another image of what that room looks like. So here's a view of the hallway that Tim steps out to take a phone call when Bill Krogstad gives him a call. You can see that the glass doors at the end of the hall when he steps out on the phone, as you see right here in this shot.
Okay, I'm here in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and this is another location that they used. This is one of the few that they used that was not in the hotel for the movie scenes that were filmed here in Ann Arbor. But this is the location of the park that Tim and Joan went to, and then later Tim goes back to the park again. But you're going to see this tree right here. There's another tree with a very distinctive limb. See how this limb comes out? It makes like a bend and comes up again. That's visible in that shot, as is this bench area here. But there was a swing set that was here. Swing set would have been right here. And you see there's fences that are here now on both sides of the sidewalk. This is now a dog park. So I'll swing around here and show you. There's a dog park over here. There's a dog park over here. But this is definitely not Cedar Rapids. This is Ann Arbor, Michigan. But in that scene where the swing set that is there, you can see this tree, very distinctive limb coming off of it, the bench, and then that extremely recognizable tree with the limb. It's all visible in that shot. So the swing set would have been right here. And I don't know if it existed here before this became a dog park or not, but this is where they shot that scene. So Tim and Joan would have been sitting here on the swing. Tim was telling her how he got involved in the insurance business. And then you can also see that building. There's a bridge, that's a road that's up there. You can see that building in that shot as well. Now there really is a river here. So when I swing over here, it's gonna look much different than what they showed in the movie. So this clearly has like a wooded tree line on the embankment of the river. This is that dog park. You can see some buildings up there. The river kind of goes in this direction, and even the embankment on the other side, there's like a nature path that's over there with some more, you know, definitely more trees. There is a large building that's on here, but this is where they superimposed a shot of Cedar Rapids. So if you remember, you can probably get an idea of how wide this river is. There's somebody riding their bike across the other side right now. It's not terribly wide. If I zoom in, you can probably see. It's, I don't know, I'm gonna guess it's maybe like 35, 40 yards across from bank to bank. But the river in the movie, when they showed this scene with them, like from behind, was much wider. And there weren't any of these trees, and the buildings were different. There was like a Quaker Oats building. So I'll show you the overlay of the building in Cedar Rapids that they superimposed in that shot to make it look like they were indeed sitting at a park in Cedar Rapids. But it was not, it's Ann Arbor, Michigan. Okay, so this is the location in this that they used the scene of when the scavenger hunt started. So there would have been a little bit of a stage, like a platform that Oren was standing on. And you can see these two beams right here in his head. Oren would have been kind of standing like right here. But the group was sort of gathered out here listening, you know, to the rules, I think, of what the scavenger hunt consisted of. And then he gave them their first hint, which had something to do with, I think, like water or under the sea. I can't remember exactly what he said. But they ended up running down this ramp. It was to go under the pool. So they went down this ramp right here, which would take you to the pool. So this is where they all go running down here to the end of this ramp to the pool to unlock, you know, the gate to go in and start the scavenger hunt. And there really is a lock run right here, just as it was in the pool where they kind of reach around. And so this is obviously the pool area. Looks very, very much like it did in the movie. The only thing missing really was there was a spiral staircase that was here, kind of like went, wrapped its way up to that second level. There used to be like a decorative wall that sort of looked like a mural that was on this wall here. I don't know why, but that was done. Now during the scavenger hunt, the whole group of people were lined up on this part of the pool. They were lined up on that little walkway that's over there. And you can tell that was the shot. That door is very visible, as is this opening in the gym. I think that the poles were a different color, but that's where they were all lined up, and they were looking at the letters in the water, trying to figure out what it was. And Dean's, he had his Green Bay, Wisconsin sweatshirt, would have been standing like right over there. But the scavenger hunt part of the pool would have been right there. Okay, and here's the exact spot that they shot, the scene where Tim and Joan are doing the scavenger hunt, and Tim figures out the first clue, and they're running to go find the second. So they come right down these steps right here. You can see that railing in the shot, and something that's very distinctive in it is this. There's sort of like a wooden covering for the room that's behind it, but it's like sort of like a, I don't know what you would call it, sort of like a fencing, like with the little squares in it. But you clearly see that in the shot when they come running down, the steps here.
Okay, this is a quick exterior shot of a location that you don't see from the exterior. You only see interior shots. It's the second stop of the scavenger hunt when they're in the barn competing. This is the Rentschler Farm Museum. It's just outside of Ann Arbor. But this is where they have the giant ball pit that they dive into looking for a red ball, and then they have the hot dog eating contest. That was all filmed right here. Okay, and here's another exterior shot of a building you do not see from the outside. The part of the structure that you see on the left, the far back left, is actually Planet Rock. It's a rock climbing center that's in Ann Arbor, Michigan. And you can see the little awning here. It's where they had the next stop of the scavenger hunt when they were doing the rock climbing wall. And of course, Tim gets up towards the top, and then he kind of freaks out before being lowered. But they shot that scene inside of this center in Ann Arbor. So here's a shot of Tim and Joan driving. This is actually a part of Cedar Rapids that they use for the filming of the movie. So look at the building in the top left. You see OPN Baird on the brickwork. Here's that same building, and you can clearly see that marked on the side. This is in Cedar Rapids. And then as they are driving to the restaurant, look at the elevated covered bridgeways in Cedar Rapids connecting the buildings. You'll see them right here in this same image. So this is the intersection that Tim and Joan drove across in the movie on their way to dinner. Okay, and here's a look at the interior of the Pacific Rim. It's a restaurant in downtown Ann Arbor. This is where Tim and Joan go to dinner after the scavenger hunt. Take a look at the booths in the background. See the very high backs of those booths, sort of like a privacy wall of sorts. Here's another shot of the restaurant. And again, you can clearly see the very high backs of these booths.
Okay, so this would have been the scene where they're going into the wedding. The wedding would be in the ballroom, which is right behind these doors here. But unfortunately, as I said, with COVID, everything's locked up.
All right, and here is Tim and Deansy inside that building during the wedding reception when they were in there dancing. And take a look behind Tim. You see that darkened area that is sort of like a stage or a curtain. Here it is off to the right. It sort of has like that purplish light shining on it. That was directly behind them in that shot.
Okay, so this is the upper level of the hotel. It has like a walkway that kind of like zigzags its way through the upper level, sort of like breaking up different parts of the lower level. But up here, it's all open air. You can see it has like the wooden roof, the skylights, and the natural light that comes in. But if you remember correctly, when Tim, Joan, Deansy, and Ronald were throwing the ice, they had the ice buckets and they were running through this upper level. You would definitely see one of the angles that they shot that scene from right here. So you see those two doors, again, the room numbers are gonna be different, but this little placard mount that's right here, you clearly see Tim and Joan. Tim is like kind of like bending down, he's like kind of leaning right by this, and they shot that scene right here. And of course, then they kind of run in the direction that I'm filming, throwing ice and kind of ducking down behind things, going in the direction that I'm walking here. So this is also the gate that you would have seen Deansy, Tim, and Joan come through. They filmed it right from where I'm standing, where Deansy was, I think like Tim had said something about the pool closed, and Deansy was saying how he just opened it or something like that. But he reaches over, unlatches it, just like you see in the movie. That's how this gate is set up. And they come in here to the pool area. I'll swing around and show you. Looks a lot like it did in the movie. Really, really similar to what it looked like in the movie. And there's the rooms. So they would have gone down right along this side of the side of the pool here on this little sort of like a patio. And Deansy goes over. He gets the lid of a trash can. Have no idea if this is the same one or not. But he puts the lid of the trash can on his head. So I don't know if that's the same one that he used it. I'd have to look at the movie, but this is where that took place. And of course, this is where Joan and Tim would have gone into the pool, right down these steps. So if you remember, like when Deansy gets the lid of a trash can, he puts it on his head, sort of like a helmet, and he goes down to the steps. He goes over in this part of the pool. You can tell because it's that 4-foot marker that's right there, you can see that visible in the shot. And then Joan and Tim would have come down into the pool right over here as well. And I'll show you something else over here. So when Joan and Tim are in the water, again, they were like right here. And you can see these in the movie. They're like dolphins that are on the bottom of the pool. Those are visible during filming of the movie. But when Deansy's over here with the trash can lid on his head, yeah, you can hear, they're making racket. And that's when Oren comes and stands at this railing and he's looking down at the pool, and that's where he sees them. And then of course, Tim and Joan get out of the water. So they run, get their stuff. And one of the things missing as there used to be a spiral staircase that was here. Now, I don't know if that was used, if it was already here and they used it for the movie, or if it was added for the movie and has since been taken out. But the spiral staircase would have been right here. And that's what Tim and Joan ran up to that level. And then they run down. Joan's room would have been right here. And then Deansy, Tim, and Ronald's room would be right over here, kind of like just tucked in behind that wall over there. That's where one of the suites was. And then Oren's room would have been up there, as I said. But when you see Deansy get out of the water, he like pulls down his pants and is mooning Oren. He did that right here. So he was just left of the 4-foot marker. So he would have been laying like on the tile over here with his ass hanging out. And this is the view back towards where Oren was standing. So I'm now in the upper level, and you can see the pool area is right down here. And this is where the spiral staircase would have dropped, led you up from the pool area. So it would have been like right in between these poles right here. So it would have, this wasn't here. So they would have, Tim and Joan would have come up here, and they would have run down. Joan's room was right there. It looks, the number is different than it is in real life. Her room was 209. So when Tim and Joan come running down the hall here, they turn the corner and they run by those windows, and they key in. So they shot it from like further back pointing. So if I zoom in, get a little bit better view. It would have been room 209 in the movie. It's not 209 in real life, but that's the room that they would have used. But the footage would have had them running along this thing, the wall there, the glass wall there, and then stopping at that door. Okay, so after Tim spent the night with Joan and feels guilty, when he wakes up in the morning and comes out to call Macy, Joan's room was right there. So they don't really show him walking out of the room, if I remember correctly, but they definitely show him standing right here. So he's got like a towel wrapped around his waist and he's on the phone trying to call Macy. And he starts walking in the direction that I'm shooting from. And there was a housekeeper that was right over here she kind of gave him like a weird look as he passed by trying to call her. But he would have come right over here and he would have stopped, kind of like sat down on the floor here calling Macy. And that's where that cutout was for the spiral staircase that's no longer here. But he would have sort of been like sitting on the floor, leaning up against the poles right here talking with her. And after he's on the phone call with Macy, he looks back kind of like through the bars here, if you can kind of follow my finger here, down in this direction right in there is where he kind of sees Deansy. Deansy's like passed out on a table down by the pool. So when I stand up here, you can see a couple of things that you can see. Those people are standing there, but you can see that sign and that wall, that railing, and there's like a little bit of like a landscaping, like a tree and some mulch that are down there. But the table that Deansy would have been passed out on would have been right down there. That's where that scene was shot. Okay, so I'm still here on the upper level, and this door right here would have been the door for Oren's suite. It would have been 215 in the movie. I definitely remember the number being 215. I don't think it said New England suite. I think they changed that sign up as well. But this is where Tim, towards the end of the movie, comes to meet and talk with Oren in this suite. His suite would have been on the level below, and then Joan's room would have been down over here. But again, the door would have swung in this direction as well on this suite.
Okay, in this area right here is where they had the tables set up where they're having drinks, and where Joan, Deansy, and Ron were sitting and waiting when Tim was at the party before he called.
Okay, so I came down here to the far end of the hotel just to show you how open it is in here. And from what I understand, that's one of the reasons they selected this hotel, is they wanted a feel of like a Midwestern hotel with a pool, and it certainly has that. So you can see it's only two stories as far as the rooms go. There's the ceilings, got the skylights and the wooden ceiling that's over there. But this is all open here. But basically everything they did from filming standpoint would have been from like right where this couch is towards that wall, from over from that wall towards the entrance. So a majority of the movie was filmed right here in this hotel, in this general area. So it fit the bill for what they were looking for, and this is what they used